your wife has joked on Twitter about having the baby and taking a selfie and sending it to you after the game. That's obviously got to be a relief to you that she's so easygoing about the situation. But how do you balance the emotions of and the anticipation of having a child with the focus and preparation for the game?
It's just a matter of I can only focus on one thing at a time anyway. She knows that. I'm one-track minded, so it works pretty well, I think, knowing that she can handle herself, and she's a strong woman, so she's already kind of let me know that if we're in the middle of a game, she's probably not going to tell me anything that's going on, and that's fine, you know, because I trust her, and I trust the people that are around her, our family members that are with her and stuff right now, and, you know, I just go from, you know, when I'm here at the field, I'm focused on what I have to do with my job, and as soon as the game's over and as soon as I get my post-game work in, I focus on my family and take care of them. So I just separate it as much as I can.
Okay, last one, Ben, standing over here.
As a follow-up, is there a contingency plan in place just in case something does happen while you're in New York?
If something happens while we're in New York, you know, like she has the baby here, well, if she has the baby, then there's nothing I can do. I'm that far away. I mean, certainly.
It's an airport right next to the city.
Certainly, yeah. But, you know, obviously, you know, if it's a family matter and it's an emergency and there's something that I need to be there for, I'll be there. But barring that, you know, if I'm gone, she said, you just better hit a home run if I have the baby without you.
Thanks for coming in, Ben. That concludes.